our next guest actually comes from the 10th Congressional District. She's been a friend of the program and friend of WJR for quite a while. It's Representative Lisa McClain giving us a little bit more perspective from the Republican side of the aisle on the president's speech last night. Good morning, Lisa.
Hey, good morning. How are you?
Fantastic. So I've got to ask, were you actually in the chamber when you saw the speech, or were you outside the chamber?
No, I watched it at home with my family. You know, there was a limited amount of people there, and we only got 40 tickets, and unfortunately, I'm a freshman, so...
I completely get it, and I think you probably were in the best. You had some great seats then. Listen, what was your reaction?
I had a front row seat.
Hey, there you go. What was your overall reaction of the speech?
So I thought about this a lot last night and how to package it, because I feel like I was a little kid on Christmas morning, and there's this big, beautiful package underneath the Christmas tree, and it's got wonderful wrapping paper and a big, pretty bow, and that's the first package I want to open up. And I open it up and there's a lump of coal in there. That's the best way I can describe Biden's speech, is we as Americans have to unwrap the package and really see what's in the package. And
I think that's a great way of putting it.
And what's in the package is extremely troubling. And if you think about it, from this perspective. We just got the Q1 2020 numbers. 6.4 GDP growth. And you heard the President Biden say last night, we are in this robust economy. All right, what does that tell you? That tells me a couple things. The policies of the free market, which has been in place for the past 4 years, they actually work and they helped us get through the pandemic.
Well, that's what we saw during the Trump administration.
Exactly. And if that's the case, and we have such a robust economy, which the numbers prove it to bear out, why do we need all these stimulus checks? I mean, think about this, Rocky. In this president's first 100 days, he has spent more money than any other president in the history of our nation. $2 trillion, right, in the first 100 days. He's proposing another $4 trillion with infrastructure, and I say that tongue-in-cheek, in the family plan, not to mention anywhere from a $10 to $100 trillion Green New Deal. He's proposing in his presidency minimum of $30 trillion. And his answer on who's going to pay for that is big business. That's not the case. There's no way big business can afford to pay $30 trillion of our deficit, let alone an additional $30 trillion. It's just not happening. And if the American people unwrap that package and see what's underneath, tell me how raising the income tax helps. That's not big business. Tell me how raising the capital gains tax and the dividends tax. That's not on big business. That's average America. The payroll tax and investment on partnerships and S-corps, that's not big business. That's your local diner that you eat at for breakfast. That's not Amazon. So again, sure. what I would encourage is open up the package and see what's inside.
So as you raise more taxes, you agree, and you're actually saying that as we raise more taxes, more companies will actually seek safe havens like offshore or going back to China or going to Mexico to produce their goods to bring them in instead of producing them here.
Or worse, they're going to hire less people. They're going to pass those tax increases on to middle America.
Well, you bring up a very good point, because he actually was quoted as saying, I inherited the worst economy since the Depression, and we're going to do once in a generation investment. And do you remember when he said that once in a generation investment? But all of his programs that he said during the speech are perpetual. They're continuous spending. There's no once one generational investment. They're perpetual, and they keep spending year after year after year. Well, so how are the Republicans in Congress going to fight this when it comes in front of them in the House? Because you're down by 6 votes in the House, correct?
We have to get the American people to unwrap the package. because we have to stop. The family plan sounds really good. Infrastructure sounds really good, right? Everybody, let's agree that we need infrastructure, right? But let me just give you some facts on infrastructure, which is, to me, is crazy. Think about what we're going to pay on infrastructure. Only 5% of the infrastructure bill goes for roads and bridges. Less than 2% of the bill goes to waterways, locks, dams, ports, and airports. Less than 5% goes to broadband. Where's all that other money going? I'll tell you where that all other money is going, on pork programs. So if we're going to do an infrastructure bill, let's actually sit down on a bipartisan, unified basis, like he said, and argue and debate. We don't do that. That's words. And let's hammer out an infrastructure bill. But a $4 trillion infrastructure bill where less than 5% of it goes for roads and bridges, that's not an infrastructure bill. That's a Biden bailout bill.
I don't think anyone could argue with your reasoning. I think you're absolutely right on. We've got 2 minutes. Let me ask you, in those 2 minutes, why do you think he didn't touch immigration reform? Why didn't he touch the crisis at our southern border?
It's interesting that we have a climate crisis, right? But we don't have a crisis at the southern border. And he won't even go and look to see if we have a crisis. I mean, we have a crisis in our own American children's system with foster care. Yet we are going to burden that with all of the illegal migrants that are coming over right now, or immigrants, excuse me, that are coming over right now. He doesn't want to touch it because he'll lose. That's why.
Yeah, you bring up a very valid point. One other thing that I want to get your input on in the last 30 seconds. He actually also was quoted by saying, "No amendment to the Constitution is absolute." I thought that was the craziest comment a president could ever make.
Right.
I thought the Constitution protects us from the government.
Thank you. But did you catch this comment, Rocky? Is, which I thought, we the people is the government? we the people are the people. He said everything we needed to hear. I believe that we the people means we the government. No, we the people means we the people.
Yeah, Lisa McLean. Lisa McLean, the congresswoman from the 10th Congressional District. Lisa, we applaud you for coming on and sharing your thoughts. And I, for one, agree with you 110%. I thought you summed up the speech very well from the couch of your living room. And we should do this more often. Thank you for joining us today, Lisa.
All right. Take care. Have a good day.